Hi, my name is Dave Coplin and I'm delighted to be able to welcome you to our first edition of Seeds for the Future TV, a new web show that aims to bring you incredible insight about leading-edge technology and its impact on the world around us. From 5G and the Internet of Things, right through to the transformational power of data and artificial intelligence, in each episode, we'll be asking an industry expert to walk us through some of the key innovations, opportunities, and challenges these technologies will bring specific areas, helping us to understand not just the technology itself, but also how we can all make the best use of it, whether it's in the world of work or in our personal lives at home. This week, we're focusing on the role of AI in sport, looking closely at how the relationship between humans and machines can help create achievements and experiences that take human performance to an entirely new level. To guide us through these opportunities and challenges that a world of AI-enabled sport might bring, it's my absolute pleasure to introduce you to our expert guide, Dr. Kishore Biswas, who joins us from Huawei's Global Training Center. Welcome, Dr. Kishore. The floor is yours.
Thank you, Mr. Dave. Hello, everyone, and welcome to our Tech Talk. I'm Dr. Kishore Biswas, the IT Training Director Engineer from Huawei Global Training Center. Today, we'll explore many exciting AI innovations in the field of games and sports. Let's get started. Since the first time when IBM's Deep Blue computer beat Garry Kasparov at chess in 1997, DeepMind's AlphaGo AI program beat World Go champion Lee Sedol in 2016, till the recent Beijing Winter Olympics 2022, the sports world has embraced the exciting era of artificial intelligence. In today's talk, we'll focus mainly on the following three topics. Number one, enhancing athlete performance through AI coach. Number two, improving the mechanics of sports through AI. And number three, audience and fans experience in 5G plus AI enabled stadium. In Beijing Winter Olympics, curling robots were deployed as AI coaches. As we know, AI is revolutionizing many aspects of sports, such as coaching techniques and players' performance. AI coach is an application that uses machine learning algorithms to analyze sports data, players' skill set, generates insights from it, and provides suggestions on how coaches and athletes can make better decisions about their training and gaming strategy. AI coaches can also help athletes by providing personalized feedback about their form, technique, or mental state during games and matches. In 2022 Olympics, these curling robots tracked the position of the stones and calculated where they needed to be delivered in order to keep them from knocking into each other. They simulated the curling throwing process, which can help athletes predict potential game situations before they even occur. Researchers and scientists from the Harbin Institute of Technology in China created this robotic curling coach that used a combination of image recognition, artificial intelligence, and an automatic control system to implement these curling robots. Let's now focus on how AI can improve the mechanics of sports. We might have heard of or experienced such technologies as Hawkeye, or Video Assistant Referee, or VAR in short. These technologies are becoming a new norm in modern sports. Hawkeye tracks objects by using multiple high-definition cameras with 340 frames per second and deep learning algorithms. The system works via 6 to 7 high-performance cameras, normally positioned on the underside of the stadium roof, which track the ball from different angles. The video from these 6 different cameras are then triangulated and combined to create a 3-dimensional representation of the ball's trajectory. Hawkeye is said to be accurate to within 3.6 to 2 millimeters. It can measure where an object ball is at any given time, as well as its speed, direction, and can predict its likely final position. This information is then shown on television screens or mobile devices so that viewers can see the predicted path of the ball, making it easier for them to follow the games as they're watching it. Thus, Hawkeye has been called the most successful piece of technology ever developed for sports. The reason for this is that it has been able to provide viewers with a much better understanding of what's happening on the field, even if they can't see things from their own perspective. Okay, have you ever thought about AI taking over the role of a human referee in future sports events? Well, video assistant referees are becoming more and more popular in the world of sports. They are being used in many leagues, such as the Premier League, Serie A, Bundesliga, and La Liga, etc. They're also used in other sports, such as basketball, baseball, and hockey. The video assistant referee system is an AI-enabled tool that helps the referee make better and more accurate decisions during live games. This system is able to check for offside, goals, penalties, red cards, and mistaken identity with a high degree of accuracy. The use of VARs for soccer matches is a recent introduction that has caused controversy among fans. The main argument against the use of technology is that it takes away from the human element of a game that is supposed to be based on skills. However, many argue that the benefits outweigh the concerns. Well, well, well. Let's get to another exciting part. Is there anyone here in this audience who hasn't heard about 5G technology yet? Well, 5G is the next generation of wireless communication. It is expected to provide faster speed, lower latency, more stable connection, more capacity, and more bandwidth than the previous generations like 4G and 3G, etc. 5G networks allow for a hyper-connected world with applications for many industries. Among them, stadiums have been at the forefront of this new era of connectivity, since stadiums are one of the very few places where people come together in large numbers and use their mobile devices at high frequency. 5G will enhance personalization and engagement by enabling stadiums to offer an improved audience experience through better connectivity, improved network resiliency, and better content delivery. 5G connectivity will also make it easier to access the internet from your mobile phones, and you will be able to download content instantly. This means that stadiums with 5G connectivity can provide instant replays of the game in 4K resolution on stadium screens, as well as live streaming of games to fans at home. The stadium will be able to provide an immersive experience for the viewers, such as allowing them to select their own camera angles, statistics of players, and more. With the implementation of AI, 5G, IoT, and virtual reality technology, future stadiums will be able to offer completely new experiences for viewers by streaming 360-degree video and virtual reality content. And that concludes our whistle-stop tour of the ways in which AI is set to revolutionize how we play, watch, and enjoy sports. It won't be without its challenges, but it looks like it's going to make for some amazing experiences that I can't wait to try out.
Thanks, Dr. Kishore. That was an amazing presentation. There's so much to think about. For me, what really stands out is how we are using technologies like AI to fundamentally change the role and capabilities of the humans. If we go back to your first example of the curling robot coach, it strikes me that successful teams now need more than just human talent. They need some pretty advanced technical skills and presumably some pretty big budgets as well to be able to afford everything. As this starts to become more prevalent, do you think that sport will be cease to be about human talent and instead be more about those who can afford the best technology?
That's a great question, Dave. I think your concern is valid, at least at the beginning when advanced AI capabilities are still not available at every corner of the globe. However, as we progress in this technology, it would be far more open and much more affordable for national teams of most countries. Therefore, in the long run, I believe it would still be a fair game. Moreover, no matter how much assistance we might get from AI coaches, there will always be some human factor in the game deciding the final victory.
Thanks, Dr. Kishore. That's really fascinating. Let's move on now. And I wanted to pick up on your point about the AI assistance being offered to referees. I would guess that given the speed of developments and the opportunity provided by technologies like 5G, we'll soon be reaching a point where the technology will be better than the humans. Do you think we'll ever see a time when we no longer need human referees?
Well, as we know, computers are much better at data processing and calculation than human, but it is still far behind human in abstraction and reasoning capabilities. AI platforms are good for solving specified problems, but generalized AI or universal AI is really far away from now. As long as AI makes decisions based on big data analysis, I think it is not likely to surpass human talent. After all, implementing human creativity, emotion, and sixth sense may not be possible in robots. Therefore, I believe we will still need expert referees with AI assistance even in the far future.
That's great. So finally, the potential of AI and 5G-enabled stadiums is going to make for some amazing fan experiences, regardless of whether they're in the stadium or elsewhere. Do you think that will result in a drop in audiences being at the game in real life? What do you think that stadium owners and sports teams should be thinking about in order to maximize attendance both in person and on screen?
Yes, 5G and AI-enabled stadiums are going to provide amazing fan experiences, which would be much better than now. That means our in-stadium experience and on-device experience would be improved a lot. But due to the distance and various network infrastructure in various places, in-stadium experience would still be better, in my opinion. So the ratio of in-stadium and on-device audience might be similar. But the overall experience would be fascinating for sure.
Okay, that's great. Thanks, Dr. Kishore. One last thing before we go. I know you're in this amazing position of being able to watch all of these developments in technology and how they impact sport. Can I ask, what is the one innovation when it comes to AI in sport that you personally are most excited about?
Good question. Right now, our AI capabilities are mainly big data based. Our machine learning and deep learning models are trained from extracted dataset. with our mostly serial CPU capacity, this data-based learning mechanism is a big bottleneck to surpass human capabilities. There's this exciting technology these days called quantum computing, which promises to give us much faster and flexible computing speed. So to answer your question, AI 5G with quantum computing is the technology stack that is most fascinating to me. This would truly bring AI and sports to a new level.
That's amazing. Thanks once again, Dr. Kishore. So what do you think? Are you a sports fan that's desperate to see the amazing new things that AI can bring to your sport? Or you'd prefer to keep the technology well out of it? Whatever it is, why don't you tell us what you think in the comments? We'd love to hear your views and your ideas on for how you'd like to use AI and other technologies in the world of sport. Well, that's it for this edition of Seeds TV. We really hope you've enjoyed it. If you've got ideas or questions about topics that you'd like us to focus on for our forthcoming episodes of Seeds for the Future TV, we'd love to hear from you. Simply drop us a comment on this video or come over to the Seeds for the Future community on LinkedIn and tell us about it there. Thanks for watching. See you again next time.